So you're vegan, you've read the starch solution, but you're still not losing weight? I got you covered. Here is my little basket of tricks, and in this basket of tricks, I have 5 things that are keeping you stuck. Watch this video to find out how you can release weight, what's keeping you stuck, and let's get this thing going. First and foremost, you are not fat. You currently have excess fat on your body. Having excess fat on your body does not label you as a fat person or a bad person or anything of that matter. You currently have excess fat on your body and you are looking to take care of it by watching this video, which tells me you're a fantastic person if you're watching this video. We cannot berate ourselves into better health. We have to be neutral about it, actually. I'm not gonna say we have to love ourselves into better health, just be neutral about the fact that you currently have excess fat on your body. And that's that, and we're gonna take care of it there. Hello. Okay, on to the video. Hello, my honeys. I'm Emmy. Welcome to my kitchen. If you are new here, welcome. I'm Emmy. You're a healthy honey. I'm the creator of the Slim on Starch program, where you work with me as well as a mindset coach and a nutrition coach to release weight on a plant-based diet. Today we're gonna be talking about just a little touch of the things that I implement with my clients so that they can go from this to this, and here are some more transformations that the clients go through, and this is just a little bit of the bag of tricks. There's a lot more in there. Starting out with number 5, I am pulling out nothing. This sphere of nothing that you see represents what's called meal amnesia. Meal amnesia is a survival mechanism that we have as humans. Remember, our brain is the same brain that we had in the Stone Age. And usually when things aren't going well for us as humans, whether it be anxiety or health issues, it's because there's a mismatch between what happened to us during the Stone Age and what happens to us during 2021. So let me give you an example with meal amnesia. When we are living in the Stone Age, there is a possibility that we would die from famine. So one of our survival mechanisms is to keep us searching for food at all times, just in case a famine comes. There's 2 things that are gonna keep us alive as humans, food and sex, and so we're always on the hunt for both of those. Now, meal amnesia is something that causes us to forget when we've eaten something. So what I tend to see happen with a lot of clients that I work with is once they start taking pictures of the food, which is what I do with my clients, they have to take pictures of the food and submit it to their nutrition coach, they say, wow, I didn't realize that I was eating a lot of things that were just sneaking by my lips. But now that I'm actually taking note of it, I'm eating a lot of things and I'm forgetting about it. So a lot of times people have very pure intentions and they truly believe that they are doing the starch solution, they're doing a whole foods plant-based diet beautifully, but forgetting about a lot of the things that are sneaking into their mouth. A lot of the culprits of this are moms who eat off of their kids' plate, or if you're at work in the break room and there are some muffins, you just pick at a little things here and there. Chips at a party, just a little bit of something. You go to a restaurant, you have a little bit of the chips and salsa that they have on the table. We forget about these things. And it's not because you're a forgetful person or a bad person or somebody who's not committed to their health. It's because you're a human. And we have this survival mechanism called meal amnesia that causes us to forget about the things that we've eaten. I would suggest that you start taking note intentionally of everything that you're eating to make sure that you don't fall into the trap of meal amnesia. Because if you follow this lifestyle to a T, you're going to fall to your body's optimal weight. Okay, let's see what else I have in my bag of tricks. Why am I pulling out bread? Because it's important for you to know the difference between dry starches versus wet starches. Bread, along with things like crackers and tortillas, is a dry starch, which makes it more calorically dense. So bread and crackers, these are gonna be 1200 to 1600 calories per pound, versus wet starches, which are things like potatoes, rice, bean, corn, oats. These are going to be 300 to 600 calories per pound. Now, let's say you eat 2 pounds of food in a sitting, and that 2 pounds of food is made up of dry starches. Well, that's gonna be maybe 2,400 calories, versus if you eat 2 pounds of potatoes, which are 350 calories per pound, then you're only eating 700 calories. Because we don't count calories on this lifestyle and we're eating foods that are naturally lower in calories, if you're looking to maximize your weight loss results, you're going to want to stick to the wet starches, which are things like I listed, rice, beans, corn, potatoes, sweet potatoes, yams, squash, because they're lower in calorie density as they have the water intact. These dry starches, bread, corn tortillas, crackers, they've had the water removed, which makes them more calorically dense. So zone in on those wet starches. Next up in my bag of tricks, I have a little 100 calorie pack of almonds. The package is like triple how many almonds are in here. Let me have a feel for how many almonds are in here. Okay, I think there's maybe like 10 almonds in here. I mean, it's tiny. It's, my cat could eat this. Now, if this is 100 calories of almonds, let me show you what 100 calories of lettuce is. This is 100 calories of lettuce. This is 100 calories of almonds. So I know people will say, well, Emmy, I just have a very small amount of almonds, so it's not a big deal. But when your stomach only has a limited amount of room, if this is the size of your stomach and then we put some almonds in it, well, that's not gonna fill up your stomach. If this is the size of your stomach and then we put this in it, it's going to fill up your stomach. So it's going to displace and reduce the amount of food that you're gonna eat later on. So if this is 100 calories and this is 100 calories, which one of these do you think is gonna keep you more full? This one is going to keep you more full because it's lower in calories. These richer foods, the nuts, the seeds, avocado, tahini, these richer foods are going to not only displace the amount of calories that you eat later in the day, but are also gonna cause you more frustration because they're healthy whole foods. So you're gonna say, what the heck, what gives here? I'm eating so healthy, why aren't I getting results? And it's because of these richer foods. These are not unhealthy, these are not bad foods, they are simply a richer source of calories. And they take up less room in your stomach for the same amount of calories as something like vegetables, which are about 100 calories per pound. So if you are incorporating these richer foods and you're not seeing results, then let's put them back into the basket of tricks. Next up in the basket of tricks, I have something that is technically McDougal approved oil-free, and it's these Mary's Gone crackers. You know why they're called Mary's Gone crackers? Because they're gone in about 6 seconds. These are technically, they're oil-free. They have fantastic ingredients. I mean, look at these ingredients. Brown rice, quinoa, flaxseed, sesame seeds, spices, garlic, rosemary, sea salt, tamari. And they're organic. So they're oil-free. They're a totally healthy food, but let me run the calorie density on this real quick. Retired math teacher mode activated. Hey, really quick, if you are enjoying this video, please hit the like button and hit subscribe. It really supports my channel. Oh no! This is how many calories per pound that food is. When I round down, it's 2100 calories per pound. So if you eat a pound of these crackers, you are eating 2100 calories. If you eat a pound of this, you're eating 100 calories. I could eat this whole package. You could eat this whole package. Let's be honest. We could all eat this whole package. We're humans. The calorie density is not in our favor for this one because this has 6 servings per container at 140 calories, 140 times 6, that's 840 calories in this package that I could finish eating by the time I finish this video. Do you know how many pounds of vegetables you'd have to eat? 8.4 pounds of vegetables. That would be tough. Just because it's oil-free, McDougal approved, it has clean ingredients, doesn't mean that it's gonna be the best weight loss food. And the last thing in my bag of tricks is this tomato sauce. Not particularly this tomato sauce, but buying anything that has a label, really. Because these things that have labels, although you'll hear, you know, pasta and pasta sauce and steamed vegetables is a great McDougal approved meal, this pasta sauce has a lot of hidden ingredients in it. It has soybean oil, it has olive oil, and a lot of times they'll sneak some cheese in here too. Now, the good news about pasta sauce is that it's very easy to make on your own. You can buy crushed tomatoes at the store and you can add in garlic and basil and oregano and minced garlic and onions and mushrooms, and you can make a gorgeous sauce of your own just with crushed tomatoes as your base. You don't have to buy these, which have a lot of hidden ingredients in them. If you are super lazy, like yours truly, then you can go to Whole Foods and get their 365 brand, the Whole Foods brand, no sugar added marinara, and it's no oil added either. So they have oil-free marinara at Whole Foods, so I would recommend that. You can also get, Trader Joe's has one too, and it does have some sugar added to it, but it doesn't have any oil added to it. Okay, it's called their organic spaghetti sauce. Here's what it looks like. So that one does have a little bit of sugar added, but sugar really is not as big a deal as oil is, because oil is the most calorically dense food product on the planet. It's 4,000 calories per pound, totally unnatural. Just a little tiny tablespoon of oil has 200 calories, 14 grams of fat, and it goes right by you. You don't even see it coming. If you try to eat 200 calories of lettuce, If you want to work with me as well as a mindset coach and a nutrition coach and get results like this in the Slim on Start program, then click to apply to work with me in the down bar. Go to healthyemmy.org. I'll see you on our call. I love you, honeys, and I'll see you in the next one. Woo!